Now, sad news in entertainment. Sylvia Latore, dubbed the Philippines' Queen of Kundiman, has passed away. She was 89. She died peacefully in her sleep, according to her granddaughter, Ana Perez de Tagle Klein. The former Disney star paid tribute to her grandmother on social media, thanking her for passing on her love of music. Latore began her film career at 7 years old. She went on to perform and entertain for 8 decades. She's also dubbed as the First Lady of Philippine Television. Now, an unconventional shade for an unconventional time. Pantone declares Viva Magenta as the color of the year for 2023. The color authority described Viva Magenta as a nuanced crimson-red tone that expresses a new signal of strength, dynamic and positive without being aggressive or even overpowering. It adds the color also offers a new vision, which the Institute believes is needed to forge a more optimistic future following the onslaught of challenges that people have faced in recent years, like the COVID-19 pandemic. The U.S. government donates thousands of HIV test kits to the Philippines to mark the observance of World AIDS Day. As Rafael Busano tells us, the donation will help detect the rising number of HIV cases in the country.
In just a decade, the average number of Filipinos newly diagnosed with HIV has risen by nearly 5 times. From an average of 9 in 2012, it grew to 30 in 2017, 34 in 2021, and 42 this year. From January to October, over 12,800 have been diagnosed as HIV positive. The Department of Health attributes the rise in cases to the inability to access testing services because of the COVID-19 pandemic. But they also admit that public understanding about HIV remains low.
Isa sa mga dahilan na nakikita natin na pagdami rin ng mga kaso dito sa young population ay hindi rin pa rin ganun kalalim yung pag-intindi ng ating mga kababayan tungkol sa kung ano ang HIV at kung paano ito iiwasan. Patuloy pa rin yung ating ang panganib sa HIV dahil sa low level of awareness at low access to the services, no? Hindi pa rin kasi mataas yung paggamit natin ng mga condoms among at-risk population.
There are no unique symptoms for a person with HIV. What's mainly affected is the immune system. If the virus is left unattended, the immune system will weaken, making a person vulnerable to any disease. But perhaps the most common disease among people whose immune systems have been affected by HIV is tuberculosis. But unlike previous years, HIV is no longer a death sentence. There is hope. Like the case of Elena Felix, who has lived with HIV for nearly 3 decades. After religiously taking medication, her virus load can no longer be detected, which means the virus is now untransmissible.
Naniniwala kami, kailan pa natin bibigyan ng tamang information ang mga kabataang ito kapag infected na sila? Katulad ko, infected na ako nung nalaman ko ang tungkol sa HIV. Hindi na rin natin dapat ikinahihiya ang pag-uusap tungkol sa sex kasi naniniwala ako na habang kinukubli natin ang pakikipag-usap tungkol sa sex, mas lalong nagiging vulnerable ang ating mga kabataan.
To increase the country's capacity in testing, United States Ambassador Mary Kay Carlson led the turnover of 86,000 HIV viral load test kits to the Philippines.
These tests are vital to helping the Philippines move closer to achieving its goal of controlling one of the fastest growing HIV epidemics in the world today. More importantly, with this donation, we aim to amplify the hopeful message of you equals you. That undetectable is indeed untransmittable.
Like other pathogens, the topic of HIV should also be taken seriously. To do this, a person, especially one who engages in risky behavior, must get tested because the earlier the status is determined, the sooner the treatment can begin. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.